What's up, Ozones? Welcome to the Ozone and welcome to a long overdue video summarizing the story Friendly Face, as well as giving my analysis on it and a few small thoughts about it you could take into consideration for yourself, a few theories. So, before I begin with the story, I do want to take a moment to say that this book is really, really good. It really made me happy, especially this story in particular. I honestly think that the writing is incredible, and at the moment, Friendly Face as a whole, I would say it's my favorite book. It's strong all around, and of course the epilogue was the extra cherry on top. I've actually done a video on the epilogue already, and I'm planning to do a little bit more touching on that, but that will come in the near future, so don't you worry. Okay, let's start with a quick summary of everything that went down in this story, Friendly Face. So we meet Jack and Edward, who are best friends. They have been for their entire lives, basically. And after school, they come across an abandoned cat. So they adopt it, and name it Faraday, after Michael Faraday, who studied electromagnetism and electrochemistry. Months go by until Faraday follows a butterfly into the street. Jack chases after it, but they both get hit by a truck. And Edward, of course, is very devastated. He's lost his only two friends, his best friend and his cat. One day, Edward comes across an advertisement by Fazbear Entertainment showing their Friendly Faces service, which recreates a lost or dead pet using animatronic parts. To do this, they need DNA from the pet, so Edward goes back to get some hair from the incident, but accidentally takes some of Jack's hair instead, because they both have black hair, so yeah. It was 10 weeks later, the package arrives, and Edward is horrified to see that Jack's face is put on the animatronic cat instead of Faraday's. In fear, he buries the robot in the backyard while the face just stares at him, smiling. So creepy, just... During the night, Edward stays awake in fear as there are sounds from all the way around the house, loads of different weird sounds. Eventually, the cat covered in mud appears at the bottom of his bed. Edward's mother comes in wondering why he's screaming, and the cat is gone. It's disappeared. So over the last few pages of the book, Edward is being stalked by the Friendly Face. He sees the face everywhere he goes, but as soon as he looks at it, it disappears. So one day he finds the Friendly Face on the street when it chases him down onto the road, where Edward gets hit by another truck. The Friendly Face sits by the dead body, wanting to play with him some more. But of course he can't, because he's dead. I think I really love the setup of this story, and the ending made it that much better as well. But there's probably a few things we should talk about concerning the FNAF lore. The first thing I'll touch on is kind of obvious. Two beings were killed, and both ended up in the Friendly Face in some way. I think a lot of people are going to say that this is evidence for Golden Duo, which is the theory that there are two souls inside of Golden Freddy. I do believe that theory, but I don't think that this story provides evidence for that. Golden Duo came in all the way back from the survival logbook, when two souls were present in kind of Golden Freddy's kind of arc, I guess. The new kid then presented two children springlocked at the same time, literally in Golden Freddy's suit, and together forever. Spoilers is about two girls who together possess Rosie, who is literally a springlock animatronic. However, as the Friendly Face isn't exactly a springlock animatronic, it's run by DNA, and was made by Fazbear Entertainment as well, I don't believe that Friendly Face is another piece of evidence for that theory. What I will say, however, is that this story kind of closely relates to that of Mangle in some theories. I know a theory I had a while ago was that Mangle was possessed by both a dog and a child, and I think it's better to use this as evidence for those kind of theories over Golden Duo. I think it's time to get to some of the bigger points in today's video, and that is who all the characters could potentially represent. Ignoring Faraday, you've got Jack, who was killed by an accident, and Edward, who witnessed it and got killed because it tormented him following the accident. Now, there's two big paired character parallels I can think of here, so I'm going to try my best to explain both in quite a nice fashion. First of all, we have the classic Michael Afton and Crying Child parallel. Now, although Jack and Edward are not brothers, Edward was there when Jack was killed, and he does shortly blame it on himself. In fact, he doesn't really know who to blame for the incident, much like the bite. Was it Michael's fault? Was it his brother's fault for crying? Was it the animatronics creator's fault for the animatronics being unsafe? It's kind of this torment that I believe both Edward and Michael go through after their losses. I think both of them regretted it, whether it was their fault or not. And both have nightmares about it too. Speaking of nightmares, it could be possible that Friendly Face is supposed to represent Nightmare Fredbear, and the nightmares Edward has is a parallel to FNAF 4, but a bit more on that sort of parallel later. I do see a few flaws with this kind of logic though. As I said before, the characters aren't brothers in the first place when there's plenty of other stories about two brothers. Michael doesn't die similarly to his brother either. I also just don't think it's what the story is supposed to be about. All of this malarkey about Friendly Faces just to tell us that, well, what does it tell us? Here's something about making parallels. They need to have a purpose, I think. Why would we need these two parallel, the Crying Child and Michael, in the first place? It just doesn't really make sense. We're kind of forcing a parallel, if you know what I mean. Which is why I think I have a little bit of a better idea. The idea is that Edward instead represents the Crying Child, while Jack represents Cassidy. I know what you're thinking, but let me just explain it first. You know what I was saying before about Golden Duo not playing a part in this story? I'd actually say it gets hinted at a little bit here. So let's talk about the incident. We know that the Crying Child saw something, which is why he's scared of the animatronics. What if that something was a murder? Okay, we don't know what it is. It could be a murder. This is going to sound like a stretch at first, of course. But what if the Crying Child and Cassidy were friends? And what if he was even friends with all the other missing children too, which is why he sees them as friends before he flatlines? Granted, for this to work, the missing children's incident would have to be before 1983, but I don't personally have any issues with that. The Crying Child saw Cassidy's death, but then why does he see her face everywhere? I'd say this is rather similar to the way you see the one you should not have killed's face in the Ultimate Custom Night Easter egg, which is ironic because many people believe that is Cassidy. And while we're on the topic of the one that you should not have killed, I want to show you a detail first pointed out to me by Q and Fancy, which is the fact that the one you should not have killed has a very similar facial structure to the face on the front of the book. Now, I understand that artwork may not be consistent, and it's very possible that this is a huge coincidence, but it is something. Now, when I hear faces connected to FNAF, yes, I think of that UCN Easter egg, but the other big thing I think about is the Fredbear plush. This is the reason this parallel could be very important. Cassidy dies, and her soul, or a DNA, or Agni, or whatever, is now in the Fredbear plush, represented by the Friendly Face. Theory is called Cassidy plush. We know that William Afton does in fact look through these plushies from the room in Sister location, but the other thing about these plushies is that they're everywhere. Just like in Friendly Face, the face is in bushes, in gutters, in windows, in trees, everywhere. But it's just a friendly face, the face of an old friend. This implies Cassidy was there in the Crying Child's final moments, and also the further possibility of Golden Duo, but I don't know. Now yes, I do actually believe everything I said there. I'll admit though, there are some pieces of evidence that are a little bit out there, and for this to work, a few more things might need to be in place, like the MCI being before the bite, but I like the theory, and I always have. Make sure you tell me what you think in the comments, or if you think someone completely different. Tell me if you want me to make some more of these kind of videos for Sea Bonnies and Together Forever. And yeah, I'll see you then. Goodbye.